What up, bitches? It's the misanthropic one, aka He Who Hungers, and I'm back up in this bitch for another rant slash review. I know y'all been waiting for this one right here. Heavy Metal Kings are back with their latest album, Black God, White Devil. I've talked about Heavy Metal Kings before. You know, they're a group comprised of Vinnie Paz from Jedi Mind Tricks and Ill Bill from Non-Phixion and La Coca Nostra and shit like that. So, no need for any introductions here. I'm just gonna jump right into this shit. This is one of my most anticipated albums of this year. You know, I got a few messages saying, when are you gonna review this shit? I think it just came out, what, last week or a week before? So I got a few listens in. Here is the cover. You got a briefcase with two guns and some packs of coke, or yeah, I'm assuming that's coke. On the back, you have half of the Heavy Metal Kings insignia, 13 tracks on that bitch, okay? You open this bitch up. That's the CD there. And behind it, I forget if there's anything. Yeah, it's the Heavy Metal Kings logo or insignia right there. So let's put this CD back. We'll look at the insert real quick. A lot of the inserts do this nowadays where they'll just put the front cover on the back. So it's sort of like a poster type thing. Here you go with the production credits, liner notes, and all that shit. All right, so we'll jump right into the productions and the features on this bitch, okay? Production, you got Sunday from DSA Commando. Great fucking producer, very underrated. You got Apathy, shout out my brother Apathy. You got Vic Grimes. Giallo Point, I guess that's how you say that. You got shout out to DJ Eclipse. He does cuts on Golan and Globus, which is track 5. Yeah, Giallo Point is on here a few times. Same with Sunday, same with Vic Grimes. Shout out my homie C Lance. I haven't heard from you in a minute, brother. You got Blaster Beats on here, MTK, and shout out my homie Sick Nature from the Snow Goons. He does the last track, Fuck Outta Here. All right. So, these guys, they gotta have hard body ass beats, you know, especially fucking with Paz. You know, I've always said Paz has a distinct ear for production and on the underground. He knows production, all right. So production, you know that this shit is hard body. I mean, you know, that there's no question about that shit. Let's get right into the features, which is really easy. You have Gore-Tex, who appears on here 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 times, which is well over half. And you have DV alias Christ. Shout out to him. DV alias Christ, this dude, he's sort of like an enigma, man. I mean, this guy been around forever. It's time to drop that album, brother. You know, he's very unique. He's one of the first guys to actually start doing the rapping and harmonizing type shit from New York. So check him out, DV alias Christ, all right? But Gore-Tex is on here fucking 7 times. I mean, let's get right into the album, okay? Pros and cons. Pros, like I said, is hard body ass shit. Love Ill Bill and love Vinnie Paz. It's what you expect from them. This CD isn't really too content driven though. It's just hard body ass rhymes for the most part, you know, except for like the hook on Killing Technology and shit like that. Track four, Bad Hombres. I like the beat. The beat actually goes with the title of the track. It has like a Latin feel to it. It was fucking great hearing fucking Gore-Tex on some new shit. Cause Gore-Tex is a dude. I reviewed the Gore Elohim album that he put out, Electric Lucifer, when he was going under that name. Fucking classic shit, man. And I love hearing Gore-Tex, especially with some new shit, cause he's kind of been obscure, you know, except for that album. He's kind of been around, like you hear him on other people's shit, but it's good to hear him on this. And you know, you guys should have just inducted him into the group, because he's on here for over half the album. So to me, he's already part of Heavy Metal Kings. When I saw him on Facebook and he was promoting this shit, and I saw his name was on the track listing mad times, I'm like, dude, you're in the fucking group. You're in the fucking group. This is Non-Phixion minus Sabak Red and, well, DJ Eclipse, I guess. But he was doing cuts on one track. What was I gonna say? Track three, I had an issue with that, Egyptian Moses. Loved the track, but it kind of threw me off, because you know, Bill had a hook, and then you had Gore-Tex come in, and I'm expecting the hook after that, and then fucking here comes Paz right after that, spitting his verse, and it kind of threw me off there a little bit. Gemini Lounge featuring Gore-Tex. I can't help but say Gore-Tex titled that one because he's done work with the Gemini Lounge. Shout out to Genghis Khan and John Jackson, all the people that work with Genghis Khan. But Gemini Lounge is a production group that Genghis Khan is involved with. Check his shit out, by the way. Great underground MC. But yeah, this is a great album. I totally enjoyed it. I would probably give it right now, I would probably say an 8. It's a quick quick listen. It's not too overbearing. I'd probably give it an 8 out of 10 easy. Very solid album. Very hard body. I need this right now. Shout out to Vinnie Paz. Shout out to Ill Bill. Shout out Gore-Tex, DV Alias Christ. Yeah. That's it. And all the other producers involved with this project. That's it. Everybody else, y'all know the deal. Leave your love. Leave your hate. Most of all, subscribe. Support dope shit. And that's it. Peace, bitches.